So far we have discussed regarding the bar graph, double bar graph, pictograph and histogram. Now let us go to the next topic, circular graph or pie chart. Have you ever seen the data represented in a circular form? So a data can also be represented using circle graph or pie chart. Let us take an example to understand it easily. The time spent by a child during a day is given in a circular form, and here the whole circle is divided into sectors, and here each sector represented by an activity of the child during a particular day, like sleeping, school, play, homework and others. Now the child is spending 8 hours during the sleeping, and the child is spending 6 hours during school, and 3 hours in play, and 4 hours in homework, and 3 hours in other activities. Now how to divide a circle into sectors? Means, so in the circle graph or pie chart, the whole circle is divided into sectors. Now here each sector represents an activity or an information given in the data. Now let us find what is the size of each sector in the circle. So how the circle is divided into sectors? Here the size of each sector is proportional to the information in the given data. So here the size of the sector representing sleep and size of the sector representing school. So these all, the size of each sector is proportional to the value, means proportional to the value in the given data. Now let us find the whole day, means 24 hours. Here 24 hours is divided into 8 hours, 6 hours, 3 hours, 3 hours and 4 hours. Now we will find the proportion of the time in sleep. Proportion of the sector representing sleep equals to, so here it is represented by 8 hours, means number of hours in sleep by whole day. So the number of hours in sleep is 8 hours. So whole day consists of 24 hours. Your hours get cancelled, and 8 ones are 8, 8 threes are 24. So this is 1/3 of the whole circle. So the proportion of the sector representing sleep is 1/3 of the whole circle. And we will find the proportion of the sector representing school. Equals to number of hours in school by whole day. So the number of hours in the school is given that 6 hours. So your whole day consists of 24 hours. Here hours get cancelled, and here 6 ones are 6, 6 fours are 24. So this equals to 1/4. So here we can understand that the size of the sector representing school is 1/4 of the whole circle. So the size of the sector representing sleep is 1/3 of the whole circle. Then what is this angle? What is the angle represented by the sector sleep? And what is the angle represented by the sector school? Now let us find the angle represented by sector of sleeping. So here 1/3 into the total angle at the center is 360 degrees. So 1/3 into 360 degrees, then we get 3 1s are 3 and 3 1s are 3 2s are 6, 3 0s 0. So this equals to 120 degrees. So here we can see that it is 120 degrees. Then what is the angle of the sector school? So this is 1/4 of the whole circle. So we will find the angle 1/4 of the whole circle means 360 degrees. So this equals to 4 1s are 4, 4 9s are 36, 0. So this equals to 90 degrees. So the angle of the sector school is 90 degrees. So this is right angle 90 degrees. So similarly, we can find the angle of each sector made at the center. Here the circle graph or it is known as pie chart. So it represents the relation between the circle and its the whole circle and its parts. Here the whole circle is divided into sectors. So that is why the circle graph shows the relation between the circle and its parts. Now let us see how to draw a pie chart or a circle graph. So the one question, the favorite flavors of ice creams for students of a school is given in percentages. So the flavors are given the chocolate, vanilla and other flavors, and the percentage of students preferring the flavors. So 50% of the students prefer chocolate and 25% of the students prefer vanilla and 25% of the students prefer other flavors. Now we will draw the another table. So to find the proportion of each sector representing chocolate, vanilla and other flavors. So here first column we will take the flavors of the ice creams, chocolate, vanilla and other flavors. In the second column we will take the percentage of students preferring the each flavor. So here chocolate is preferred by 50% of the students and vanilla is preferred by 25% of the students and other flavors are preferred by 25% of the students. So then we will find the fraction of each sector representing chocolate, vanilla and other flavors. Now 50% means we can take 50 by 100, so this equals to 1/2, and 25% means 25 by 100, so this equals to 1/4, and the other flavors 25%, so this 25 by 100, this equals to 1/4. So the sector, the proportion of the sector representing chocolate is half, 1/2 of the whole circle. And the proportion means size of the sector representing vanilla is 1/4 of the full circle. And the size of the circle means size of the sector representing other flavors is 1/4 of the whole circle. Now we will find the fraction of 360 degrees. So 1/2 means 1/2 into 360. So this equals to 180 degrees. Means size of the sector representing chocolate is 180 degrees of the whole circle. So the size of this sector is 180 degrees at the center, and the vanilla is 1/4 of the whole circle. So we will take 1/4 into 360 degrees. So this equals to 90 degrees. Next, other flavors 1/4. So here also 1/4 into 360 degrees. So this is also 90 degrees. So angle of the sector representing chocolate is 180 degrees. And angle of the sector representing vanilla ice cream is 90 degrees. And angle of the sector representing other flavors is 90 degrees. Now let us draw these three sectors in a circle. So first you draw a circle with any center and any convenient radius. Now let us draw a circle with center O and any convenient radius. Now draw a radius OA Then draw 180 degrees. So 180 degrees means it is a straight angle. So from O, we draw a straight angle. So angle AOB is 180 degrees. So this sector represents chocolate. So this is exactly half the circle, means it is a semicircle. The next sector angle is 90 degrees. So draw a right angle. Now this sector is right angle representing 90 degrees, and this is represented by vanilla. And the obviously the angle of the third sector is 90 degrees. So this is also right angle, and this is represented by other flavors. So in this way the whole circle is divided into some sectors representing each information given in the data. Now let us solve a problem. Draw a pie chart showing the information given below. The table shows the colors preferred by a group of people. So yeah, in the table the first column is given as the colors and the second column is given as the number of people. Means here 18 people prefer the color blue and 9 people prefer the color green, and red color is preferred by 6 people and yellow color is preferred by 3 people. So the total number of people is 36. Now let us extend this table to draw the pie chart or circle graph. So in the next column you will take in fraction. And the next column, the fourth column, has the central angle or in 360 degrees. So the total number of people is 36. So if you represent the number of people preferred blue color as the fraction, then we can take 18 by 36. So this equals to 18 ones are 18 and 18 twos are 36. So this equals to 1 by 2. And the green color preferred by 9 people. So if you write 9 by 36, so this equals to 1 by 4. And 6 by 36 is equals to 1 by 6, and 3 by 36, so this equals to 1 by 12. Now we will find each fraction in 360 degrees, means we will find the central angle represented by each sector. So here 1 by 2 into the angle at the center in a circle is 360 degrees. So we get 1 by 2 into 360 is 180 degrees. Next 1 by 4 into 360 degrees. So this equals to 90 degrees. Next angle 1 by 6 into 360 degrees. So this equals to 60 degrees. Then 1 by 12 into 360 degrees equals to 30 degrees. So if you add all these angles, then you will get again 360 degrees as the central angle at the center of your circle. So 180 plus 90, 270. 270 plus 60, 330. 330 plus 30 is 360 degrees. So the total angle at the center is 360 degrees. So here we got angle of each sector made at the center of the circle. Then first we will draw a circle with any center and a convenient radius, and draw a radius OA, and the angle of the sector representing blue color is 180 degrees. So we have to draw the straight angle. So this is 180 degrees. So this represents the information blue color, which is preferred by 18 people and making 180 degrees at the center. And the second information is given as green color, which is preferred by 9 people and having the central angle at the center 90 degrees. So we have to draw a right angle . So this is right angle 90 degrees. So this is represented by green color. And the next information is red color. It is preferred by 6 people and having the central angle at the center is 60 degrees. So this angle is 60 degrees and it shows the information red color. And automatically the next sector makes 30 degrees at the center, and it is represented by yellow color. So here blue color is preferred by 18 people, so we can write here 18, and green color is preferred by 9 people, red color is preferred by 6 people, and yellow color is preferred by 3 people. So in this way a circle is divided into different sectors. So that is why a circle graph or a pie chart shows the relation between a circle, the whole circle, and its parts. Let us see the next question. A survey was made to find the type of music that a certain group of young people liked in a city. So the pie chart shows the findings of the survey. So the some young people means 40% of the young people like light music, and 30% of the young people like folk music, and the 10% classical music, and 20% semi-classical. So answer the following from this pie chart. So if 20 people liked classical music, then how many young people were surveyed? So you have to find out the total number of young people surveyed. So to find the total number of people surveyed, it is given that 20 people like classical music. So the observe the sector representing the classical music, it is given that 10%. Yeah, 10% represents 20 people. So yeah, for 10% represents 20 people, then we have to find out 100% represents how many people. So we can take 100 by 10 into 20. So you can cancel 0 and 0. So here 100 into 2, 200 people. So the total number of young people surveyed was 200. So out of 200, so 20 people means 10% people like classical music. Next, which type of music is liked by the maximum number of people? So by observing the given pie chart, we can easily say that the size of the sector representing light music is larger. So we can say that the light music is liked by the maximum number of people. So it is maximum 40%. So all other given values are less than 40%. which are 20%, 10% and 30%. So the maximum number of people like light music. Next, if a cassette company were to make 1000 CDs, how many of each type would they make? So if a cassette company wants to make 1000 CDs, then you have to find out how many cassettes to be made of each type of music. So first you will find the light music. So it is 40%, so we can take that 40 by 100 into the total number of cassettes to be made is 1000. So this equals to 0 and 0 cancel, 0, 0 cancel, this equals to 40 into 10 is 400. So they have to make 400 CDs of light music. Next, we will find the number of folk music cassettes. So it represents 30%. So 30 folk means 30 by 100 into the total number of cassettes is 1000. Here also two zeros cancel, then we get 30 into 10 is 300 cassettes. Then we can find classical. So classical music represents 10%. Here 10 by 100 into the total number of cassettes is 1000. So we can cancel two zeros and two zeros. Then 10 into 10 is 100. So they have to make 100 CDs of classical music. Then the last one is semi-classical. It represents 20%. So 20% means 20 by 100 into 1000, which is the total number of CDs. So here we can cancel two zeros and two zeros, and 20 tens are 200. So they have to make 200 CDs of semi-classical music.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.